Ronnie. This is class 12 economics, chapter 9, lesson is going on. Forms of market. We have already studied in the previous video what is called market structure, what are the different types of competition, and what are the factors that affect to be called as a product, as a particular, belong to a particular market structure. As we have already studied, the factors determining market structure are number of buyers and sellers, nature of the product, knowledge about the market, freedom of entry and exit, and degree of price influence. Today we are going to understand different forms of market structure and its classification, which is basically divided on the basis of buyers' competition and sellers' competition. First of all, let us talk about sellers' competition. Sellers' competition means those producers and firms which produce a particular commodity, how they can influence the market price. Buyers' competition means those buyers who may be large in number or less in number or one single number, how they are able to influence the price in the market. On this basis, today we are going to classify the market structure or market forms into mainly five types. The first one is perfect competition, then monopoly, third is monopolistic competition, fourth one is oligopoly. All these four were sellers' competition, and the last one is monopsony, which is a buyer's competition. Let us explain one by one. The first one is perfect competition. What is perfect competition market? It is a market structure in which there are large number of sellers as well as buyers of a commodity, which the commodity is homogeneous or identical, that no individual firm can influence the price. This is called perfect competition. That means there will be large number of buyers and sellers. No seller, individual seller, can influence the price. The commodity produced by them will be identical in all respects, and no single seller can influence the price. Now let us discuss the features of perfect competition market. There are mainly six features to be called as a market or a commodity belongs to perfect competition. The first one is large number of buyers and sellers. Large number of buyers means this particular commodity which belongs to perfect competition market is produced by unlimited or very large number of producers, so that each individual producer's share is too less and they are not able to influence the price because so many producers are there. No individual firm or producer can influence the price. They cannot try to increase or decrease the price so that others will follow them. That will not happen in perfect competition market. Therefore, they are called price takers. In the same way, no buyer also can influence the price of this particular market because the commodity is such that there will be unlimited number of buyers in this for the particular commodity. When buyers are unlimited in number, no individual buyer can influence and bargain and say that I want to get the commodity in less price. Nobody can influence in this way. Therefore, they have to give the price what is prevailing in the market. So, in both the ways, by sellers and buyers, a perfect competition market commodity will be sold in a uniform or same price, and the commodity's price cannot be changed. perfect competition market, all the producers are producing a homogeneous product. Homogeneous product in the sense, the products produced by the perfect competition market producers are identical or similar in all aspects. When we talk about aspects, we can say that physical characteristics and environmental factors regarding both regarding the particular commodity will be similar. That means all those producers under perfect competition market are supposed to produce or are producing the commodity which is identical in all aspects, like the same quality, the same color, the same size, the same chemical components, and they are similar in the environmental factors. That means the location of the sellers, credit facilities, all these are similar. This particular characteristic implies that there will be uniform price prevail in the market. So if you ask a question that can you give an example for such a product which is produced by many producers and similar in all aspects, we cannot say 100% such one is there, but almost we can say that wheat is a particular example for perfect competition market product. The third feature of perfect competition market is freedom of entry and exit. That means perfect freedom for entering for a new firm and start producing the particular commodity. And the existing firms can, if they want, they can leave, and there won't be any particular restriction for entering into the market or leaving the market. Such a freedom of entry and exit has an implication that each firm under perfect competition market will earn only normal profit in the long run. That means they will not be able to earn super normal profit or losses. Maybe in the short run they may be earning losses, or they may be incurring losses or earning super normal profit. This will be wiped out in the long run due to this freedom of entry and exit feature of perfect competition market. There won't be any kind of legal, natural or man-made restrictions so that the firms have to stay in the industry. They will be able to easily move from the industry or enter into the industry. And this freedom is very important for perfect competition market producers. The fourth feature of perfect competition market is perfect mobility of resources. Resources means factors of production used in production of a commodity, which can be also known as resources. In a perfect competition market, the producers are perfectly free to exit the firms. While exiting the firms, they are able to easily switch the resources from production of the particular commodity to any other commodity's production. That is a special characteristic of perfect competition market. That means they are able to switch the resources or factors of production from one use to another very easily. And this condition is necessary for the free entry and exit of the firms. The fifth feature is perfect knowledge. The consumers, producers, and resource owners, all the three related groups have perfect knowledge about market conditions, prices prevailing in the market, etc., about the particular commodity. So when all are having perfect knowledge, there will be uniform price prevail in the market. No one can increase the price. Others will come to know about it and they won't be able to increase the price. Market price will prevail equal, and the differences will be eliminated, and price uniformity will be ensured by this perfect knowledge. This implies that all the firms have similar cost conditions regarding the production of particular commodity. The last feature is absence of transportation cost. In perfect competition market commodities, their prices do not include transportation cost. Why this particular feature exists only for this particular competition is that perfect competition market commodities are always available at the same price. There will be uniformity in the price all over the entire markets in the economy. So due to this, to maintain this, there should not be any transportation cost. Transportation cost is not added in the price, and there will be uniformity in the price because of this particular feature. Sometimes perfect competition is also regarded as pure competition. There is a slight difference only. Pure competition and perfect competition are different from one another only in the matter of degree of the competition. When the first three features exist in the competition, that means large number of buyers and sellers, homogeneous product, freedom of entry and exit. If only these three features are existing in a competition, that we won't call as perfect competition, we can call it as pure competition. The rest of the three will not be applicable for pure competition, which are mobility of resources, perfect knowledge, and absence of transportation cost. So in this way, if the first three features are fulfilled, we can call it as pure competition. If all the six features like large number of buyers and sellers, homogeneous product, freedom of entry and exit, perfect mobility of resources, perfect knowledge about the market, absence of transportation cost, if all these six are included in a competition, then we call it as perfect competition as explained above. In reality, perfect competition market does not exist in the present world, we can see. But for the purpose of study and comparison, it is very necessary to know about perfect competition. It is very difficult to fulfill all these six features in the production of a commodity. Even then, we can give some examples like wheat is a perfect competition market commodity. On the basis of the features, there are large number of producers of wheat. That means farmers are unlimited in number from all over the, if we take the case of India, from the top to north to south, west to east, so many unlimited, uncountable number of farmers are producing wheat and selling it. So they are the producers. An unlimited number of people are buying and using it. The first feature is fulfilled in the case of wheat. The second, most of the output or product produced as wheat by all the farmers are almost similar in its characteristic, color, quality. There can be a very few differentiation in the present times, but we can see it is almost similar in the appearance and quality and chemical composition. And any farmer, if they want to enter and start production with a rented land or own land, they can do it. Any farmer who want to leave wheat production, they can leave and go. And they can use all those resources as per the fifth feature. All those resources like land or the tractors or pump set, anything they can use for producing some other agricultural output. It is perfect mobility. And money also they can use it, use for capital or labor, everything can be shifted from wheat production to any other production. And people in the wheat market, buyers as well as sellers, know what are the prices prevailing in the different markets. Almost the prices are similar. And this absence of transportation cost matter may be a little non-applicable factor here. And that is why we say that present time, we cannot have all the, with all the features, there will be a perfect competition market problem. Somewhat similar, wheat or sometimes we can talk about sugar. Very few products are available in perfect competition market, exactly following all the features.